Well, without any further ado, let's begin with the presentations. I would like to call the first group, which will be presenting on the topic Advanced Concepts of Containerization Using Docker and their implementation on Sunbird and IIT BombayX platforms. A huge round of applause for them.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Pratik Kayas and my teammate name is Visa Gupta. We are here to present our summer internship project. Our project title is Advanced Concept of Containerization Using Docker and their implementation on Sunbird and IIT BombayX platform. Docker is a tool to develop, create, run and deploy application using using containers. What are the motivation for this project? We IIT BombayX and Sunbird software are using Docker. When other teams are developing softwares on Sunbird, so they have to run Docker. They face some roadblocks like listed on PPT. First is running Docker is a big step. Means Docker, when you create application in Docker, you have to interact with Docker using command line interface. You don't have any GUI tool. There are also complications with container networks. You have to connect them properly for working application. Second is, we are not used to containerized application architecture. We are comfortable in making an application in a single machine with all services on a single machine. But we are not used to deploy application using the services on running on different containers. Docker itself is running Docker is in active development, so some developers may argue that if they develop an application in Docker and Docker might stop the support for previous version they implemented. So our objective is to get people to use the Docker. There are some advantages of using Docker. First one is application of Docker. Applications of Docker have significant variety. You can set up your environment Python, Django, Node.js and try out what is the best choice for you. Second, some features are unique to Docker. Like Docker have a Docker Compose. So you can deploy your application using service in a single machine, Docker Swarm. You can make a cluster of different virtual machines or computers and deploy application on that. Third, deployment cycle can be optimized. You can add a continuous integration, continuous deployment using Docker. You just have to build an image from a Docker file and upload it to Docker Hub and directory run on a production or development environment. We studied, analyzed that case, Cornell University case study that used Docker for their solving problems. So we listed some problems they are facing and we find out how they solve their problem. First is they use JavaZen which stop receiving update. Development testing and production environment are not synced. They cannot keep up with development and release their product in production development as fast as in development. As you can see, last project update for conference they took 6 months. Original developers and engineers are not available, so they have to read all documents and configuration files for update application. After using Docker, they can implement a continuous CI and CD pipeline, so all things are gets automated. So project upgrade takes only couple of weeks now, and automatic build and deploy containers to development test and because Docker, we builded Docker image on a development and we directly run on a production. We don't have to worry about our dependency issues in production environment. This also decreases time spent on issues with the environments. We also studied another case study, General Electric. They also have some issues and they solve using Docker. They have to spend average 6 weeks to move from development to production environment. They have lots of legacy code to migrate to cloud. So they need some tool to manage that microservices architecture they are planning to move. They are using VMware. But in VMware, they only deploy one application per VM. So in using container, using Docker, you can deploy up to 14 applications per VM. Automation with Puppet has a poor adoption rate because Puppet has its own automation language you have to write in. So Docker, they use Docker-based automation software using Voyager, and also decreases the time of production to development to production, and up to 60% of code migrated in just 4 months of fix. We study some use cases of Docker network. Docker network is a component provided in Docker to communication between a Docker containers. So there are some driver options available in a Docker. There are bridge driver over a network, host network. We use them and study how Docker developer can use in a different conditions and when they can use this type of network drivers. So first one is bridge network. It is used for inter-container communication on the same Docker host. So when you are developing application which is running on a single Docker host machine, so what you can do is suppose you have a front-end porter and a back-end porter. So you run a front-end service and a back-end service and connect them using some worker service. So you can manage your data flow and everything from worker service. And there is a over a network. This is used for connect multiple container, multiple Docker daemons running on different Docker host and enable communication between them. Docker Swarm also uses this over a network to connect to enable clusters of nodes. Third one is a host network. So when you don't want to isolate your network stack from a host network, means suppose you have to, like you are developing applications like WireSec, they need your host network stack. So you want to your host network stack to provided in a also in a container, because container runs always on a isolated environment. Using host network you can do that. You can allow containers to appear as a physical device on a network. So what is the advantage of this is you don't have to use a Docker Swarm in MacVirin. You can directly connect any available network host to directly connect it to it. You don't have to connect to a Docker Swarm because it act as a physical device. We also find out some use cases of a Docker storage. Docker storage, it provides a persistent storage for using and storing data beyond the container's lifecycle. Because when container gets stopped, its writable layer got destroyed and we don't have access to that data. So we can use Docker storage for that. There are different options available for that. We can use bind mounts. Advantage of using bind mount is sharing source code or build artifacts between development environment on Docker host and a container. Like we use this type of bind mount in a Sunbird. We Dockerize Sunbird portal, so we use this type of mount in a Sunbird portal. We just change code in a host directory, and all changes get reflected to in the container. We can use a volume also. It is managed by Docker, and Docker is when you do you use that is that when you don't have a specific given directory structure, means in bind mount you have a slash home slash directory type of thing, but when you deploy in a cluster it might not have that directory structure on a different machine. So you can use Docker volume. It is managed by Docker. You can use any file structure you want, but in bind mount you have to use host file structure. There are also tempfs. It is very unique to Docker. It is storing all data into a RAM. So we can take advantage of RAM. We can use the tempfs mount into testing write heavy applications like database integration testing. So we can test database, so we can improve our read and write speed because we are storing data on our RAM. So now I would like to hand over to my friend to present the next part in a PPT.
So as my friend was talking about Docker, so it is a very good tool and it is very flexible and very performant. But when you scale the app to multiple applications, the problem arises of managing multiple Dockers, and here Docker Swarm helps because it basically helps you to manage clusters. So if like multiple machines are connected to Docker and many applications are running on them, you can basically declare what you want to do. So like I want 5 applications of my front end, 2 applications of my back end, 3 applications of database. So it provides a declarative service model so that you can declare what you have to provide and you can just go on with it. And then it provides service discovery and load balancing. So service discovery, like when you are when you are deploying an application having front end and back end can contain a MongoDB database. So you don't have to worry about if it is a single MongoDB database or it is a cluster of MongoDB. So in a front end app, you can just write MongoDB and it will get connected to that application. Load balancing, like when you are running front-end application and you are running 5 replicas of it. So Docker Swarm, what it will do is like it will, in round robin fashion, it will send a request to all the applications so that the load is balanced between all the containers. Then Kubernetes, it is a more mature form of Docker Swarm and it is developed by Google. So it provides much more features as compared to Docker Swarm, like automatic bin packing. So what it means is like when container is deployed on a host machine and there are like 10 machines, so it will automatically decide where the load is less or where we can deploy the container so that the service is highly available. And it also provides a feature of self-healing. So when a container goes down, it can automatically reprovision it and start the container from that state so that the service is not blocked. Then it is very flexible in terms of storage and networking. So it is like a Lego game. So you can, the main is Kubernetes, and you can add much more storage plugins and much more networking plugins to it. So like you can back your container on AWS or Google Cloud or DigitalOcean, and it provides many more features of networking so that it is useful for your application. So this is a typical production deployment pipeline. And the first part is basically continuous integration, and second part is continuous deployment. So what happens, like when a developer pushes code on GitHub, the code get pulled by Jenkins server. So Jenkins is basically a continuous integration tool. So the code get pulled by Jenkins server. It is built into an image, and it is deployed into a Docker containers. They are tested, and when the testing is complete, and then the rancher, what it will does is it will deploy the application to AWS or DigitalOcean or and these. So what is the advantage of Docker is you can dispose of you can start a Docker in seconds and you can dispose of in seconds. So it will help in decreasing the time from development to production. So this is main architecture of edX. What we have looked at how edX works and how edX has they have Dockerized most of the architecture for local development. So we have looked at how they have Dockerized their applications, how they have used Docker storage and Docker networking to handle that communication. There was a persistent system which edX was using, MongoDB. So we have created a MongoDB sharded cluster so that we can understand how we can set up our own sharded cluster from scratch. So in our application, sample application which we have developed, we have created 3 shards having 2 replica each. So the data will be divided into 3 parts according to hashing function, and each shard has a primary replica and a secondary replica. And it also has a cluster of config servers. So and one query router. So what it will do is like it will query the incoming request depending on where it is stored. And in case of Sunbird, what we have done is that we have installed a Sunbird on local machine to understand how it works so that we can dockerize it. And initially, some of the services like player content and actor services of Sunbird are already dockerized. But we have found out that why they have not dockerized Cassandra, PostgreSQL, and Elasticsearch. And then at the end, we have dockerized Sunbird portal and keycloak service. So in conclusion, what we have done till now is that we have learned about how Docker can be useful in different use cases. We have deployed sample applications ranging from simple Hello World application to a complex application like MongoDB Sharded Cluster or Hadoop or Cassandra Cluster. We have also looked at how Sunbird works and how it can be dockerized. Thank you.
I appreciate you finishing in time. Started 15 minutes late, but we'll delay the lunch break. Some quick questions. Here you had VMs to work with.
Yeah.
When you go back to your own institute, and this applies to all of you, if you want to use this wonderful facility, how could you use it? For example, if you have a local server available to you, let's say, in your final year project, would you be able to create VMs there and deploy this?
Yes, we can deploy it. You don't want actually a VM. You can also deploy it on a normal system.
You can also Docker works on a Raspberry Pi. So you can connect to Raspberry Pi.
So you can just start using Docker as is.
Yes.
Incidentally, Nagesh, the later architecture with Jenkins, so that is where you wanted to put that Selenium automation and everything, right?
Okay, fine.
Couple more questions on your part. This sharding, just remember one thing. This concept of sharding and all emerged when conventional storage was being used,
yes,
which did not have any intrinsic reliability. But if you look at our cloud, the OpenV storage automatically does this distribution. So sharding is implied, replication is implied, you don't have to do absolutely anything of that sort. Now when you don't have to do this, how would you deploy Mongo for scalability, for example? So you don't have to do any sharding or anything, but you may run multiple Mongo applications, each one having its own storage. What is guaranteed in such cloud environment is that the storage already has inbuilt replication, inbuilt sharding. So you don't have to do anything at all there.
Right.
And one last point I wanted to make was this automatic load balancing that you mentioned. Round robin is what you said. That
yeah,
is deployed.
That's implemented.
But is round robin the best policy always?
No.
So is there any provision for you to introduce your own load balancing algorithms or it's fixed?
No,
by
you
the
can, like Nginx is a reverse proxy load balancing server. So you can deploy Nginx on a Docker container and you can manage all the services from there.
In fact, this was the question because Nginx is a far better load balancer mechanism than the conventional one.
Yes.
All right. Thank you. Good
Thank
work.
You.